Imagine this MSF hospital near a conflict zone. There's sufficient space, staff and technical infrastructure to provide treatment in satisfactory conditions to up to 10 emergency cases at the same time. Any more than 10 casualties requires activating the Mass Casualty Plan, which the teams rehearse to ensure everyone is aware of the procedure to be followed. Then one day it happens for real. Several bombs have just gone off in a market a few kilometres away. The hospital is alerted. 50 casualties will arrive in about 15 minutes. The doctors inform the hospital director the Mass Casualty Plan needs to be activated, and a siren is immediately sounded to warn the entire hospital. The first priority is to clear the hospital of any patients well enough to leave. As many beds as possible have to be made available. Then staff get prepared. The casualties will be dispatched to four zones, green, yellow, red or black, depending on their condition. In each zone, beds and medical supplies must be prepared and sufficient staff mobilised. As soon as the plan is activated, staff interrupt their routine work and proceed to their assigned posts. For example, the person in charge of hygiene in the paediatric ward goes to the red zone to disinfect beds that have been freed up. As for the two emergency room doctors, one goes to the red zone, the other to the yellow zone. All entrances to the hospital are closed, except one, which serves as a first filter. No more than one accompanying person per patient. To enable the teams to work as efficiently as possible, anyone else accompanying a casualty must wait outside. The next step is triage. A doctor assesses and assigns a colour to each patient. This decision has to be taken quickly using several simple criteria. If the patient can walk and has no worrying injuries or symptoms, it's a green case, the least urgent, and treatment can wait a few hours. If the patient is lying down and not breathing, or if the doctor judges that the hospital does not have the necessary resources to save their life, it's a black case, by far the hardest decision to take, and the patient receives palliative care. If the patient has worrying injuries or symptoms, or is showing signs of neurological, respiratory, or cardiovascular distress, this is a red case, necessitating priority treatment. All other cases are dispatched to the yellow zone, where they can wait an hour for treatment. Hospital porters carry the patients to their designated zones. In the red zone, emergency room doctors stabilise the patients, and the surgeon decides who requires surgery and in which order. This system enables the saving of the greatest possible number of lives. After attacks in Pakistan and in Yemen, for example, MSF teams have had to treat hundreds of casualties in the space of just a few days.